Alright. Ali up. Marlo up. Oh, you boring dog.
Night night, Aubrey. You got me coughing now. Dusting me mouth. Ugh.
Here we go. Oh, pulled the curtains too hard now. Oh, you're annoying me. Can't be bothered. I'm not fixing it.
Mally up.
Ali up. Yeah, go over there. Get off, we're done. Divvy. Hello, Anna Susan. A bomb deal. Still hot. Actually, forget about it. Mm-hmm. See if the guitar's in tune. Will you stop? You're interfering with my guitar. Yeah. I fell asleep last night. And he closed my eyes for a second and I was out. I was gone. I woke up half past 10-ish, I think. Kitchen, get in your bed or get up here. Come on, Ali up. Come on. Don't be walking around.
Send a letter to Capris.
they made a recipe for your eyes and took the twinkles from the stars, placed them inside of your eyes. Toil for hours and hours just to pay for your dress and all your wedding flowers, and the dress will be made on the finest silk threads. It will fluster the priest and turn every man's head as she graced the aisle with those curves and that smile and that smile, 'cause she's a natural girl. Natural girl. And your veil will be handmade by nymphs who blushed at your beauty when they caught a glimpse of your legs and your arms, your feminine charms, your charms. 'Cause she's a natural girl. Send a message to my father up above. Tell him I found this girl, the one I'll truly love, the one that he sent down from heaven up above. She fits me just like a glove. And he missed it, 'cause you're a natural girl. Climb by the highest steeple. At the top of my voice, I'll sing to all the people. I found the girl I love, the one from above, above. 'Cause she's a natural girl, yeah. And she's a natural girl. See your name is written in the stars, 'cause you're a natural girl. Well, I got a new keyboard and mouse. It was knackered yesterday. I think that's why I fell asleep, because the mouse was playing up on the keyboard. The space bar's not working. It's probably best I didn't stream last night. I probably ended up winding myself up. Ah, yeah. To you, by now you should have somehow realized it isn't true. I believe anybody pretty well it spins. That's why the flat earth wins. Backbeat, the word is on the street, that's the flies have been called out. I'm sure you hit it over far, but you never helped but glow it down. I don't believe anybody proved the earth it spins. That's why the flat earth wins. And all the globes they showed you, they were lying. All those pigs from satellites we're CGI-ing. There are many proofs that I would like to prove to you, but I don't know how.
Too fast.
I said you alter. Have a pick of Ben D. Walter. Cause after all, we live on a ball. Today is gonna be the day, gonna prove this glow to you.
Why the flat earth wins,
yeah. Backbeat, the word is on the street, that's the lies being called now. I'm sure you heard it all before, but you never helped it blow it down. I don't believe anybody proves the world is spins.
Missed it.
Spin. Why the flat earth wins. And all the globes, they showed you they were lying. All those pigs from satellites were CGI-ing. There are many proofs that I would like to prove to you, but I don't know how. I said you alter. Have a pick of Ben D. Walter. Cause after all, we live on a ball. I said Walter's level. You've been fooled by the devil.
Fooled by the devil. Yes. Ben D. Walter. My gosh. And if you think the world's concave and you show me bendy clouds, ballers can't show me bendy water. Concavers can't show me bendy clouds. Absolute trollop. Do 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 do. Don't start kicking me, you do. I need a music window. Oh, we should do nicely. Right, let's sing one for God, and then we'll get the Sunday night investigations underway. Throat. Better. Well, I heard there was a secret chord David played and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do you? Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the mindful, and the major lift, and the baffled king composing, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Faith was strong. Broken throne, man.
cut your hair, and from your lips she drew.
Missed it.
Out to God Almighty, the Almighty High Father of Heaven,
not the dickhead who thinks he's a woman. Thanks, Marley.
Right, let's see how this goes. No, don't even bother. I'm telling you, dog, you're not going anywhere. You're not getting nothing. Get up, lay down, get out. Oh, you want a cuddle?
Go on, then. I'll let you have a cuddle.
I'll let you have cuddles.
That's allowed.
Yeah, I'll let you have a cuddle. But I'm not playing, okay?
Yes, beautiful.
You little ginger fair ball, look at your ginger mohawk. I love your ginger mohican. You're so cute. Yes. Yes.
Right, get off me now. Go on then.
Go and lay down. No, lay down. That's you done. Get off. Look, you've moved things already. I didn't even bring the keyboard down. I've got this tiny little keyboard. I'm not used to it. Honestly, it weighs like 5 grams. I don't even know it's there. I've had a big, heavy keyboard for 10 years. I like super heavy keyboard. I don't know where I got it from. I don't even know. Maybe it was a second-hand one. But it must weigh at least a kilo out of a... what is that noise? Oh, is that Rage? It's Rage. It weighs a ton. But this one, it weighs like, honestly, it's next to nothing. I pick it up in a couple of fingers. I just pick it up, no problem. And it's actually tiny. Get off, you div. It's actually tiny. It's only, it's, I don't even know. It's not even 10 inches long, I don't think. But it's got big letters on it, and I can see it in the dark without a light on it. I've got an old age pensioner's keyboard. Keypad. Right, okay. Sorry, I'm sat here nattering to you all. Let's say hello to you all. Male and female faces. It's pretty simple, boys and girls. What we do is we examine the male and female face. Because God only made two skeletons, boys and girls, that's dogs, fish, birds, plants, everything. Everything that's a male and female. We can tell just by looking at the male face who's got the bigger face out of the two. It's a male. We draw a triangle through his eyes and down to his top lip like that, and we get a big triangle. We draw a triangle through the woman's eyes, down to the top lip, we get a smaller triangle because the face is mounted lower. It looks squashed, compacted, whatever you want to call it. Right, come on you.
I know what you want. I'm going to go out with them foxes. The minute I start streaming, I'm going to play with foxes.
Right, there you go. Giddy. I don't know what he's got with those foxes. It must be a young one or something, I don't know. But he plays out there with it for ages. Right, let's try this again. Marlow. Right, I'm good to go. Yeah, so basically when looking at the two faces, the male face spreads across the skull better. And the female's doesn't. It's like compacted look, see it? The overall shape is either square or rectangular. And an upside down egg shape for a woman. Can you see that upside down egg shape? There you go. Right. Excess of copyright material may under certain circumstances be quoted verbatim for purposes such as criticism, loose point in teaching and research without the need for permission for payment to a copyright holder. To the noddy older mate. Ain't getting no shekels. We stopped right there on Karan Oberoi. We'll come back to you in a second, KO. Let's move the main screen down so I can see everybody. There we go. And then I need to copy the screen. Let's go right there. Whenever, wherever. Take me to my channel. Don't do that. View your channel. That's the long one. Bill Gates is not a doctor. I totally agree. Copy. Facebook, Pastebook as I like to call it. Especially South Carolina. I was looking forward to a picture of Ashland as a kid. Fun, not funny, can't find one. Don't know what that is. Please do some basketball players. I've done loads of basketball players. Marty Stewart, Connie Smith, Joanna Gaines, Chip and Joanna. I've already done them all, I think. Definitely done Chip and Joanna. There is a pic. Right, let's close these windows because I'm getting put off by people messaging me. There we go. Let's go back to Facebook again. There we go. Poncho. Yep. Paris Hilton. Not a chance. Some people can't see the real easy ones. It's 8 p.m. UK time every single day except for yesterday. My mouse and keyboard was broken. 8 p.m. UK time. That's mental. I can see the letters without light on. 8 p.m. UK time. Blah, blah, blah. We're done. Caps lock off. Right, and then Twitter, let's post it to Twitter. What is that? Why is that one open? Why don't we just post off there? Yeah, that's a five-head, mate. You don't even need to skull check it. As if you need any help with that. That is huge. That's humongous. What do you mean you think it's a bloke with an head like that? Men don't have heads like that. Skulls like that. Foreheads like that. Tweet. That's Twittered. That's tweeted. I don't want to see the bed softening. There we go. That's lovely. This is lovely, and we're good to go. Right, I can come back to you all. Good evening, boys and girls. Welcome to the show. I am the livest of all transvestigators. We've been doing it for 4 years. Well, 5 years now, and for three of them, we've been on YouTube doing this. We have covered most of the main celebrities. I say most of 15,000 of them. So we're in front of the game. I made sure that I was doing, I don't know, it was ridiculous. I was doing 30 to 40 memes a day, which the algorithm could not keep up with. Could you, algorithm? Karan Oberoi was where we stopped, but we're going to go over to class, say hello to Anna Souza, was first in class. Hello, Anna Souza, how are you doing, darling? Ryan Martin, many blessings, how are you doing? Kenneth, son of man rising, Aldrick. Godspeed plus Vessin. I don't know which part of that message is from you, Kenneth. I don't know if that's your name or you did write anything. Hello, Kenneth. Monica, hello, darling. Tim Cunliffe, many risings, mate. Tia Roberta, hello, Roberta, sweetie, how are you? Jeannie, best to say. Bonsoir. Good evening to you, Jeannie. Mike Tennant, how you doing, mate? Many blessings to you. Rachel Knight, hello. Harold Maesland, Harold from Denmark. How you doing, Harold? Tack. No, tax, thank you. Hello. I can't remember saying hi in Danish. Is it just hi? I think it might be. And that's it. Good evening. Oh, Truth Duff. Sorry if I missed anyone. Good evening to you all, one and all. Let's move my arm over there. Oh, this new mouse is lovely. I'm loving it. Right, let's have a look. Karan Oberoi is an Indian singer. He's an anchor on the television, an actor from the indie boy pop boy band, A Band of Boys. That'll mean the girls then. It's like calling them boy zone. It's girl zone. The Spice Girls, we're the Spice Boys. And so on and so on. Everything you think you know is backwards. It really... Oh, from Norway. Sorry, my bad. Harold. I was close. Norway's close, right? Sweden, Norway. We are saying... what's his name? Karan. Karan. He's a Karan. He's having a Karan. We're done. Right there. You know what I'm going to say, don't you? You already know. Class of 2022. If you don't know what I'm already going to say, you should not be in class at the moment. You should be studying. Never trust a man whose eyes are too close together. Look at those bad girls. We've got a small mouth, pink lips, cupid's bow, high set ears. We've got a flat forehead. They've done all right with the eyebrow, I guess. Not the brow bone. There is no brow bone, but the eyebrow is malish looking. The Adam's apple, raisin, is in the wrong place. He's got Nana's ski sloping shoulders. Look at the state of them. Gentlemen, go look at yourselves in the mirror. You can stand a Big Mac on your shoulders. Because God created upper body strength in a man. That's almost 50-50. I'm going to take that as his face, hair face. Is that the boyfriend? Let's have a quick look at him. He's got the bigger face. He has. He's got the wider forehead look. And he's got the tall, narrow one who's widest at the top. Rather than being in the middle where these cheekbones are, look. Widest part. As someone was asking earlier on, where is the widest part of a woman? Take a look at the two skulls. Where is the widest part of a woman? If you can't see it for yourself, you shouldn't be watching. You should be studying. It's up there at the top. The widest part of a woman is in the hairline. Well up top. The widest part of a man is in the middle of his face, below his eyes, look. There's a huge difference in the widest parts of men and women's faces. You can even see it in the real one, look. Cheekbones rule, skull rules the female. Hairline rules the female. Bearing in mind, this face is tilted backwards. A woman's jawline is more angular than a man's, right? It's, what's the word we're looking for? It's more sloped. So when laying the skull down, it sits back. It lays back further than the male. The male's got a square jaw, look at the edges. So when you lay it flat, it stands upright almost, whereas the female's lays back a bit, which gives these just a little bit, it's a little bit off-putting on that one for me because I know it's laid back a bit. But there you go. We're looking at male and female skulls and the widest part of a woman is up there in the hairline. She's got an egghead. And she has got an egghead look. Slender, thin skull versus a wide shape. Bowling ball skull. Is that actually him? That is actually him. The squared eyes, the brow bone in the corner look. wide ass cheekbones, and of course, the male jaw's been feminized and the Adam's apple has been shaved down. These are simple things that you can go. When you start studying the subject yourself, you should already know these things are happening. And when people say to me, yeah, but he's got an Adam apple, or she's got this, and I'm just like, it's surgery. Go look it up. Go look it up. Yeah, but he's got a six pack. What, this? Here, you call that a six pack and a fake Adonis belt. It looks good, but it doesn't look even look. They don't look the same. There's symmetry in a man, especially on the nipples. Men's nipples do not live on different time zones. As always, we see the wonky nips look. See it? This nipple is higher than that nipple, just like Bruce Lee. The shoulder tilt, the V-shape, very soft clavicles of a woman. All they've done is give a tall woman some testosterone and human growth hormones, if they give them it, to grow them taller. Someone asked earlier on, imagine what would happen if you give a real man testosterone and HGH. Well, you can only give a real man one of those chemicals, and that's HGH. You cannot give him testosterone because he ODs, it kills him, gives him a heart attack. You cannot give him excess testosterone, he's already got enough. giving him doses of testosterone every day can and will cause heart attacks, I've read. Look at them necrotic nipples, pair of titties, close set eyes, it's a woman. They love to get the bodies out, these FTMs, and pass in front of you. Look, that looks like an iliac crest. You see it? Because it's more half a moon shape, if you imagine. Whereas a real man's Adonis belt, it's the same place, iliac crest. It sticks out a bit, comes in square, and then goes down. They never quite get it right. But you have to look at these. It's Tuesday night. And Nana's got her A cups out. You have to learn to look at what a man really does look like. And he does not look like this with a little pair of titties. His nipples are closer than his eyes almost. Reminds me of Bruce Lee, it does. I see the same body shape. Small chest, sloping shoulders, closer eyes. Oh, I thought I was out of pictures then. We're not getting anything walking. This is strange, usually the Indian... the Bollywood actors, I usually get loads of gates straight away. But this is what they've done right in front of your eyes. There's no point saying, oh, why are you trying to stop it? I'm not, it's already happened, I can't stop it. It's already been and done, it's happened, gone. The only port of call I have is to save the children. The adults should know better, you know, you're a grown person, you've got free will. If you want to pretend you're a dog, you can pretend you're a dog, your choice. But don't go around trying to get other little people, Jesus warned you not to touch them, don't go try and get the little people barking with you. Absolute nonsense. The most influential minds in the world are children. Stay away from them. Simple. Oh, look at this twat. She's pulling devil horns right in front of us, look. I think somewhere in my life, I may have pulled this sign, rock on at a concert or something, I don't know. I don't think there's any pictures of me doing it, though. When I thought it meant rock on. As a magician, that sign, during my show, I would pull it multiple times. To do magic, to vanish stuff. No, I'm not kidding you. There was a video on Globusters of me when I first started doing Flat Earth. And I said at the time, even though I knew, I'd just learnt about the symbol as a Flat Earther, that it means Hail Satan. I was showing all the Flat Earthers, our magician uses that symbol to vanish things. And we do. It's called back palming. We can take an object and flick it around to the back of our hand. That would be the only time ever I have pulled that symbol of showing a magic trick. In terms of hailing Satan, Never. It says on the top of this channel, Vade Retro Satana. You never, right, another thing, you don't hear them saying get rid of money, you don't hear them saying get rid of all these things like I do, and you never hear them say, Vade Retro Satana, get behind me, say, you never hear them say it, because they're not, Satan's in front of them. It's their God, it is. As much as you don't believe in Satan, they do. And as much as you don't want to believe in God, because they believe in Satan and made you not believe in God, God is very, very real. He literally is the scales of justice at the end of this. And it's him. It's him, the Lord Almighty, you're going to meet. It'll be his judgment that's final. And these people know this. They know the fooling you. I don't know. I don't know what that reeks on their psyche, if they've got a psyche, a soul, whatever, you know, a conscience, whatever it is. I don't know if they have, a lot of them, I'm sure, don't have the same consciences that a natural person does. Because we're not pathological liars, right? We don't go out of our way to lie to people constantly every day about the theory of gravity, the theory of evolution, the theory of outer space. It's a fucking theory, an absolute theory. Just because you've seen it on television doesn't make it real. Just because you've seen it in a porn movie does not make it real. It's not real life. You weren't there. You didn't walk on the moon with Neil and Buzz and the other girl that went Michael Collins, MC, 33 Father. You was there for none of it. You wasn't there when Jeffrey Dahmer ate his victims, when Jimmy Savile touched children. You weren't there. It's all made up. And even when you do get a recording of something, example, Twin Towers, it's still a bag of bollocks. Use your common sense. God gave you it for a reason. Look at that kink in that bat. What is this? What is that? Look at that chicken nom nom right there. Father, it's me again. I'm having mixed emotions with this Indian girl. Look at her bum. She would have been stunning. She would have been a very, very, very pretty girl. Look, never, ever, 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 ever underestimate pink lips on a man, ever. Look at that one. He's got a big con, can he? Big nose. And again, the difference in those faces. He's even got the widow's peak and she's missing it, look. She's got the sloping wide forehead. He's got the narrow, tall forehead, look. Five heads. Every country, same ratios. God didn't change anything, you know. There are regional variations, maybe to the chin, the nose. Some countries have got bigger noses. Some countries got bigger jaws. Some countries have got taller people. Regional variation. The actual ratio of growing the woman or the man in any country, the ratio remains the same. The male is always going to be bigger, stronger, and have denser bones. Thicker, stronger bonage. So, again, I'll say it again. You get in the ring with Mike Tyson with no boxing skill. She's the world's heavyweight woman's boxer. She is going to dance rings round you whilst blasting your jaw from one side of your head to the other. However, you put a real male in there. A real male with pugilistic skills. That's boxing skills. Pugilistic skills against Mike Tyson. And it doesn't matter who that male is, he's going to knock the living bejesus out of Mike Tyson, because this skull is stronger, thicker, and can take more damage than that skull. This jawline is, I mean, as if I have to show you, this jawline is massive. You have got to rock that jawline. This jawline is not massive. First male punch that hits the jawline, I'd be surprised if the jaw survived it. Yeah? I would. I'd be surprised if you didn't have a broken jaw. Because go look at all the battered wives' homes. You don't find battered husbands' homes anywhere. Just because a man lets a woman beat him up don't mean nothing. It just means he doesn't hit women. You know? Because he already knows his own strength. That's a man. That is. Look at that face. He's got a Steinway in his goblet. Just ivory Madonna everywhere. Look, that's a dude all day long. Big square blockhead, massive thick neck, and square straight flat, shoulders low. Now, it's not sloping, ski sloping, like we just saw on Karen here. Karen. Having a Karen moment. I'll tell you what there isn't. There's not a single gate shot of Karen walking. I really like this big keyboard. Little keyboard with big keys, I mean. Got you right there. There's a step. Right there. Is that Karen? There's another one mincing. It's one of those two. Karen B. Obero, Romance in Life. The Batman. I don't know which one's him. It's the one with a blue cap. And he hasn't got it on there. Dang it. I think it's that one right there. But if it could only be that one as well. I do think it's that one because of the haircut. They're both mincing. It doesn't matter. I've got him. Is that him there? Karen Obright. Knees apart. What's going on right there? Look, this massive gap should not be there. This knee should be closer in. It should be knees together. And that is knees apart. Granted to the newbie, that leg looks pretty straight, doesn't it? Knee and foot punching forward, but it's not. The actual angle of that leg is outward look. And this one is bowed inward look. See it? You see it? It's only the cut of the jeans and the trousers that's stopping you from seeing that beautiful curve on the inside leg that a woman gets as she walks. Tailors, designed to hide the female body, no less. Let's have a look. There's my woman with a diamond, and there's a man who can't even bring his foot over to walk in line. Like, he don't even bother. Second one. Is that him running? Look at that weird gap down there. Look at the way the female leg bends. Elbows out. Boom, 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 boom. Yeah, Ryan. There's a lot of men in this world that have been stopped from becoming world champion boxer, heavyweight, lightweight, bantamweight, because they're not allowed, because they're actual men. And the minute you put a real man in the ring with a woman who can box, it's good night. I don't care how good. I don't care if she's the world's champion female boxer. She's good. She's great. Don't get me wrong, she's great. Against a male that can box, she's got no chance. Every single punch is going to weigh in on it, on the female skeleton, from rib cage, arms, everything. I don't care how many muscles she's got, like Arnold Schwarzenegger, she's going to go down the minute she drops a guard, the minute she's knackered and the chin's exposed. It's good night, Vienna. It really is. Just look at the... look at how small this chin is compared to a male chin. The minute that gets rocked, it doesn't matter if it's Mike Tyson, Evander Holyfield, it doesn't matter which boxer, because they're all women. Rocky Marciano, it don't matter. As soon as you put them in with a real man, that real guy, you right, we're all blokes and women, right? We all went to school with the school tough nut, right? And in that school, that tough nut was the toughest nut. But somewhere else in another school, there was a tougher nut than our nut. And so on and so on. There's always that tougher nut round the corner. Sometimes you don't even think by the size of the lad that he could possibly win the fight. And then he does. Just outright male testosterone. Like I said, I've got a mate who's inside. He's doing life in prison because he was so violent. He did 3 violent crimes. They lifed him off. Because he was getting too dangerous for everyone around Grimsby. They lifed him off, and he's one of my best friends from growing up. And he's, honestly, I've seen him tear up pubs full of blokes, twice his size. 6, 7 blokes, one after the other. Da-dum, 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 da-dum. Like a bowling ball going through Skittles. And he's only a little guy, but the strength on him, the sheer outright... I think it's because he's got a low center of balance that does it, you know, because he's such a small guy in height, but in width, oh my gosh, he must be double me. I don't know if he is double me. He must be at least 1.5 of me. It's just the shoulders on him are huge. Proper fighter. And some men were born to fight. I don't care what anyone says. Some men, they don't need any training. They don't need nothing. They don't need boxing. They don't need nothing. They just fight. There's another one that I know called, he's got two first names. I'll just use his first name, Harry. His name was Harry. Me and my brother got in a fight with him once, hit him on the head with two planks of wood, and he still came after us. He was tough as a nut. One time in town, there was someone that owed him money, and he literally punched through the car windscreen, side window, and went straight through him, dragged the guy out of the car, the young bloke who owed him 20 quid. Because some blokes are just naturally, I know another one that split a bar. He literally, we had an oak bar. Imagine a bar room with an oak bar, and the oak bar was what? I don't know, 15 foot long by at least 3 foot wide. He split the bar. He literally split the bar. Just pure strength. And he, again, he wasn't the biggest of blokes. He was wide like Gozzy. Massive bloke to look at, but in height, not big at all. No bigger than 5'7". But the strength on it, like a raging bull, just like they say. You know when a man's angry. When a woman gets angry, it's like, it's not the same. It's not the same. I don't care what anyone says. Even if it's Mike Tyson getting angry, it's not the same. Everybody has this idea of Mike Tyson getting angry because he does it in the ring. You watched him allegedly bite someone's ear off on live pay-per-view. So you have this idea that Mike Tyson's a nutter, a loony. I wouldn't start on him in a bar. I tell you what, him in a bar wouldn't start on anyone, because the minute a bloke got up, he'd get knocked out. He would. Just like your doorman knocked Lennox Lewis out. I remember once there was a kid in one of my pubs. His name was Lee. Again, only stood, I'd say 5'9", about my size, maybe a bit smaller than me. To look at, you won't think anything of him. He knocked a doorman and two other doormen out behind him one night because there was it in his mate who didn't deserve it. You know, he was just a bit drunk and they took it out on his mate, and he jumped in to help his mate. One of them clocked him, you know, hit him, and that was it. He was like a I'll tell you what it looked like. It looked like a Tasmanian devil. It literally looked like a Tasmanian devil all over him. Literally, the speed of him was just phenomenal. And again, he was half their size, and there was three full-grown doormen who all practice weightlifting and all the rest of it, that looked the part, looked like massive men. All of them Sparko in the best Sunday suits. That's what you get for bullying people, doormen. Just remember, you're there to protect people, not just to bully people. God will make sure that you come a cropper. He always does. There was a group of kids. They were only kids. 20-year-olds, 19, 18. It went right down. In the end, the bottom end of that gang was like 10 and 11 years old. And they ended up committing a murder on a friend of mine. He was on his way home from wetting his baby's head, you know, drunk with his brother, going home. And they jumped him. A bunch of kids, just, and they were little kids. The oldest one there was about 15, I think. And they jumped all over him whilst he was drunk and killed him. And for me, there's no justice, because some of those kids got like, I don't know, 3 or 4 months for being involved in someone's murder. And the maximum one got was two to three years, I think they got, for murdering him. Because they were underage, but they were animals, you know. When I was growing up, we didn't have gangs like that. We had punk rockers and mods and all that, but we didn't just have gangs walking the streets of children. Back then, gangs of children, if a copper saw you, he'd just clip you around the ear. If you're messing around or doing out. He did. The amount of times I got clipped round the ear by my local bobbies. Pete Stocks is one of my favourites. Bolton was an arsehole of a copper. But he was a fair copper. You know, he never slapped you unless you needed one. Right, let's go back. Oh, which one is it? Oh, hang on. Are you lagging? Don't lag. Oh, there we go. Why has it gone to flicker? I didn't press that. Get off. I'm not in Flickr. Oh, it is going backwards. There we go. No, it's paused again. Have I gone forward? I've gone forward. These mouse buttons are in different orders to the ones I'm used to, I'm sure. Wait. I don't know which one's forward or backward. It's paused. It literally has paused up. There we go. Now it's going backwards. There we go. Save. Flamingo. Yeah, go on, I'll take it. It's going backwards, all right. It's not paused. Maybe it was the mouse that was slowing it down. I'm glad I bought a new mouse now. The buttons are in backwards order to what I'm used to. Now I'm going forward now. Which one's backwards? I've totally lost my way. That's backwards. 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 Backwards again. I just want that picture of your red face. Where is it? It's a big set of teeth. We've paused up again. It's still doing it. It's not the mouse then. It must be the browser. Pink lips on a man. I like that picture though. Right, I've just seen that red pig. Look at this lagging on me. There it is, that's the one I want. We'll take that as your face. Save image. And we're done. Just like that, Karen Oberoi fails forensics, folks. We are done. Yeah. Close that window. Next. Bobby Hart. Bobby Hart. American football offensive tackle. That must be who you're on about, right? Bobby Hart. Let's have a look. Bobby Hart. He looks like Kevin Hart. He's got closer eyes. Small mouth, high set ears. That looks like a fake wonky brow. I don't know what that is. That's not a brow bone, is it? It's an implant. I don't know what it is. Upside down egghead, close set eye, small mouth, cupid's bow, high set ears, no cheekbones, no Adam's apple, no trachea. I'll tell you what did catch my eye though. Where is it? There, that five head. Bobby Hart, the Wrecking Crew singer. Oh, that's a different Bobby Hart. Well, he didn't specify which Bobby Hart you want. Oh my gosh, I've done it again. He didn't specify which Bobby Hart, so I'm going to go with a footballer. Who's that? She's got some close together eyes. Is that Bobby Hart, the boxer? The wrestler? I don't know who that is, but it looks womanly. It does. Let's go back. Oh no, that was a gate right there. Did I press the right button? Oh, this is really winding me up because I don't know which button sends me backwards and forwards. There it is, that's what I wanted. Is that him? Giovanni Bernard, expected to play Bobby Hart. Returns to right tackle. Is that Bobby Hart though? That's the question. Or is that Giovanni Bernard, expected to play Bobby Hart, returns to right tackle? I think that's him. That's him though. Full mints, nice diamond, gotcha. We don't usually get the American footballer ones, do we? Usually they don't show many pictures of them in public. But that's a nice one. We're out of pictures. Let's try walking, folks. Walking. Just don't push these buttons in very far. It don't feel right. It feels like I'm not touching any buttons. I don't know if I like the keyboard. I like the mouse. I got a new trackerball mouse. I love trackerballs. If there's anybody still using a normal mouse, you're off your head. Look at the state of that gate. Look at this woman here. Look at the distance in that kneecap to kneecap distance. Because she is swinging those wide hips out. If there's anybody using a normal mouse, you're off your head. Look at this. If you don't know what a trackerball mouse is. Trackerball mouse. There it is. Trackerball mouse. There. Images. You don't have to move the mouse, look. These are the expensive ones, these big ones. And this one, that one's quite expensive as well, I think. But this is the one I've got. I've got, well, it's my second one. That's the first one I had there. With a tracker ball on the side. You don't move the mouse, you move the ball. So your hand stays still. You're not moving the mouse all over the place. You just move this. And I absolutely... Is that him? I've got to know what he's chewing on. 1 second. He's out there gregging something. What are you doing?
Not you,
it's Mark. I thought it was you, Marlo. I thought it was you. Wait. Ellie up. Yes, lay down. We're not playing.
No,
you're done, mate. Get over there. Get off. Right. Right, let's continue. So, trackable mice. Buy one, I'm telling you. You'll never buy a normal mouse ever again. There are lots of different versions of it. Yeah, get off my bloody screen. Lots of different versions of these mice. But that's the one I used to have. I don't know which one I've just bought. I should know. It was the red one. I think it was that one. It was wired though. It wasn't the same. Get off. Right, Chris Guy. You can get lost as well, Chris Guy. I've done you. What's that? Megan Fox walking, yeah. And the bathroom, right? Yeah, close that. Why have I got all these open? Oh, I'm at the end of the screen. My bad. Right. Who's this? Bobby Hart walking. I've got two. I've got one. Yeah, I can't even be bothered. One gate. Oh no, that might be another one there. What was that? I don't know, another one. There was another one. Where was it? Was it forward? It can't be forward one because I've just clicked that on. Is it the next picture? No, that's it. Got one picture of Bobby Hart. And maybe that one. We'll take that one as well. He ain't got a number 25 on there. No, he's a number 68. 51. There is no 25. Is that in there? Ow! Bless me. Inline footfall, we can take that. And then I just want your face, Bobby. Bobby. No, we'll take that one. It's bigger. No, it's smaller. We'll take that one then. Save image, and we're done. Bobby Hart, thanks for playing CSI. Next, Isabella Figuera, David Frost. Okay, let's come back. Do you know what? I just saw that loading then. Why did that start loading? That's loading as well. These windows are open. I wonder if that's what's slow. It can't be that slowing it down. Let me just open these windows. I wonder if that's what was slowing it down, all these unopened windows. Let's see, they're all circling. I'm going to click on them. And they shouldn't be, because they should already be loaded. Right, they're all loaded. Right, let's see if that works better. Imagine, I haven't properly lagged tonight, have I? Right, let's go. Isabella Figueira, actress, October 24th, Lisbon, Portugal. It must be for Ana Sousa. Let's have a look at, what's his name? Isabel. Isabel. Figuera. That's a big hand, mate. A big man hand. What's that? Is that a penis? Unlucky. He's a tucker. Right, Isabel Figuera. That is a huge... Look at them shoulders. shoulders, and then look at the huge chest. That's what I was going to say. Look how huge that chest area is there. With no boobs on it. Because it's a bloke. They're playing dress up. Oh, that's a nice picture. Where was it? That one. Now tell me, which one of those has got female eyes? Look at the eyelashes on her. She's beautiful. This Portuguese woman right here is stunning. The fella would have been handsome, but who's got the bigger teeth, look, the bigger smile? This one wins. This one's got the shadow casting jaw. This one's chin goes straight to neck, look. Whereas this one's chin travels backwards before it becomes neck. Because men's faces jut outwards. Do you know why I like this tracker ball more? Because it's got lasers in it. It uses lasers to track the ball rather than rollers. The other one had rollers on it. He's got a big head, hasn't he? This fella here. Look at them teeth. Look at that arm. Strong guy. He's a strong guy. Let's have a look at your face. Let's find a 50-50 of it. That's not good enough. It was that. Your girlfriend's got a big five head. Look at that five head. It's a belter. Yeah, so giving testosterone to women can happen, but giving testosterone to men will kill them. It's an overdose. I don't know where I read it. But I read it somewhere. I can't find a 50-50 on this dude. Look at his neck. Look at that neck. Versus this one, look. You win outright. There we go. That one I can use. Oh, it's blurred. We got another one where they're not like that. That one looks blurred. That one's better. Right. Oh, it's still blurred. Right, we'll take it anyway. Right, Isabel Figueroa, let's see if we can find his gait. Is that it there? Ooh, he's paused. He knows he's being watched, but it's a straight leg lock. Can't find your gait. Can't find your gait. Can't find your gate, as if. Uh-oh, oh, I thought it was out of pictures then. Isabel Figueroa. He doesn't walk anywhere, apparently. Now I hope. Oh, no, it kept going again. I'm still looking. Oh, no. We're out of pictures. Isabella Figueroa walking. Oh, look at the footprints. Circles in the sand and around and round. Go ahead, can't see them. One male gate. And I still haven't found what I'm looking for. That is nothing. It looks like we're leaving. I'll give you a second crack on the cake and see if we can catch him this way. Public. No, he doesn't walk anywhere. Sorry, Anna Souza. That's the closest I've got to him walking. No, he sat down. Size of that toe. What's that one there? He's standing again, look. Look at the way they stand to contour and try and make hip shapes. Skinny ass man legs. There he is trying to walk like a woman. Just one problem, look. The knee is looking inward and this knee is looking inward. Totally wrong. That knee should be bent outward. That knee should be bent outward. Practice. Study. Learn until you know these things for yourself. He's a tucker. He's on Max Men. Is that what it's called? Max Men. Well, there's a maximum man right there. Right, we're done. There's no gates. See you later. Next. David Frost. Do you know what? I think I've done David Frost, but we will check. Copper. Back file. Are we in the big file? Or are we in the little file? We're in the little file. Open the big file. There we go. H's and pastes is and search. David Frost. Nothing comes up. Are you kidding me? How have I not got Frosty? I could have sworn I've done David Frost. I could have sworn that I have done David. Wait. Let me check the downloads. Because if he's in the back file, he's waiting to be done. Frost. Nope, this folder is empty. Right, let's do David Frost. It's a simple one, it really is. He looks like Christopher Walken. I was walking the wrong way. Close set, rounded eyes, small mouth, high set ears, flat forehead, dial M for Mongo's. David Frost. Look at that. He looks like someone else. Look at that width in that skull line, in the hairline, both of them. The widest part is in the hairlines, look. President Nixon, David Frost, absolute upside down egghead look. So this is the same as tic-tac shaped rather than egg-shaped. It looks more tic-tac. Again, the five heads, what's doing it. David Frost is obviously a woman. You shouldn't need any help with that face. Look, it's an upside down egg. They had these weird characters for men, right? They're these soft, effeminate men. All the way through life, we've had them. The tough acting woman, you know, Bruce Lee, Jason Statham. I was going to say that's Michael Sheen, not my guy there. Why is that not going backwards? There we go. That's going forwards. It is working, it's working nice. All right, save image. No, wait, we ain't got any gates. That's the face I'm taking now. The one that looks like Christopher Walken. Now we're going to see if we can find him walking. Is that the wife? Let's have a look at him. Three little girls with buck teeth. Look at this one. She's so coy. The corrugated throat, the long arms, square shoulders, the deep-set squared eyes of Mrs. Frost, Mr. Frost. There's a skeletal difference, look. You can see it. It is noticeable, right? The neck o'clock. This is no neck. It's that simple. This is your woman. This is your man in disguise. We just need gates for David Frost. Let's see if we can find him. He's on the street there. It's like, ooh, is that a stair fail? Oh, it is. A broken leg. A broken leg. David Frost. Davina Frost. Female by design. Is that another one there? What's that? She's looking a bit bloated there, isn't she, Grandma? That one is backwards. I'm trying to remember which one's backwards on this new mouse. It's the wrong way around. David Frost. Let's see if we can find a couple more gates. Is that Maggie Thatcher? It is, look. You don't get to sit next to him unless you're a hare. And there they are together, look. Tell me, which one of them's got a wider face, a bigger skull? It's quite simple when you see them. Let's go back. There we go. We're looking at David Frost. Is that another one? No, same picture. We're looking at David Frost, world famous interviewer of the rich and famous, journalist, whatever you want to call it. I don't care. Just another liar as far as I'm concerned. Pushed a load of nonsense on the people during her life. Lied to the world. Now, I don't know how that works out for most people, but if you know you're lying to the whole world, there must be a certain amount of bad feelings you get, guilt. Then you must be feel guilty, surely, for lying to innocent people. Hello, now then, cheese. It's Tom in it. Is that Tom or Jack? I can't remember which one's cheese. It's you in it, Tom. Dennis Norden, look at that queue line on those. Look at the X Factor in there. Dennis Norden. Alan Wicker, there's another one. Look how close together Alan Wicker's eyes are. Upside down, egghead. Because we've seen them, so many. Whoa, stop the bus. Oh, that's what's his name, isn't it? Her hair. She, looking at that picture, she looks really wide there, look. And the arms, they're supposed to come down 60% of the body, not 50. That is very feminine looking. Look at the distance between the hand and the foot, look. And it's the same distance from the hand to the shoulder. And that's not how it should look. The hand should be 10% further down for a man. This should not be here. I'm seeing a woman's figure there. I really am. That's one of, what was his name? Don Kohler's world tallest man. That's a very weird shape. That looks like a woman to me. Even though she's got these massive... Remember, a woman that tall is going to have broader shoulders, bigger hands, bigger feet. But it's not going to be the male equivalent of it. He looks very odd, that giant. It does. Let's go back. Back. Come on, don't you dare pause. Did I press back? Why is it blocking up on me? There we go. And again, that's taking ages. The browser's still not working correctly. It's taking too long for these pictures to go back. I'm out of pictures. David Frost. I've only got like one gate, haven't I? I don't think there's any. Alan Wicker was pretty hard to get as well. Have I done Mark Bolan? Yeah, I think I have. Let me have a quick look in the back bar. That's neat, that's neat, that's neat, that's neat. I really love those tiny feet. Bolan. In the back file. There it is, Mark Bolan. Yeah, I've got him. 1 second. Let's drop Vegas into that window. Let's paste that one over. And Mark Bolan. Close window. Open Vegas, bink. There we go. Mark Bolan, absolutely. Do you know he looks like one of my ex-girlfriends, Tom? He really does. The psychopath one, Danielle. Daniel, the nutty one that said she was going to drown Horatio. Literally said to me, in fact, I'm going to drown your son. She's lucky I didn't take her to the River Red and drown him myself. I'm telling you, Tom. Because at that time when I started learning all of this, I was just so... raw to everything. Everything went out the window. 10 years before, I'd have dragged her out of the house by her hair, threatening to drown Roche. Soft, close set eyes look, small mouth, sloping jawline, had a chin implant, no neck look, literally no neck at all, Tom. Really thin neck as well. And then 1 flamingo, 2 flamingo, 3 full mints, 4 full mints, 5 full mints, 6 full mints, 6 shots, 4 full minces. Mark Bolan, biologically female, Tom. There's none of them survive it, Tom, I'm telling you, man. The only people that pass are people like me and you, Tom. The men that I've met in my life, most of them have been like you, me and you, Tom. Correct skeletons. But then there's heaps of them that are not, Tom. And it took this to teach me that I've been living among them. They live among us, Tom. They do. I got a love bite off Amanda. And you know who that is, right? When you was with Roxy told you. The footballer's wife. That one gave me a love bite, Tom. And it's a bloke pretending to be a woman. All my life, I knew no different. Every time I did a party for them, that man got a kiss on the cheek from me because I thought it was a woman. And I shook his wife's hand. I shook the wife's hand and kissed the husband. Tell me that's not backwards, Tom. Tell me that's not backwards. And that's the bit that they enjoy, apparently, is the utter confusion that it's caused in this world. That is that Princess Diana? That really looks like it. It is Princess Diana, right? It is. How come David Frost is so tall? I'm confused. Is he really that tall? David Frost was tall, yeah, he was. For a woman. Tall woman. That's not a good shot. Look at these two dudes, Diana and this fella here. But yeah, as I was saying, I wasn't supposed to know that I'd kissed a man, that I'd got love bites off a man, etc. I was supposed to have died, gone to heaven, met the Almighty High Father, and have him show me, play me life back for me and say, you know you did wrong. Yeah, I did, Father. I stole, I cheated, I lied. I was an absolute idiot during my living life, Father. Yeah, but that's not what we're talking about, Peter. We're talking about the sins you don't know about. What do you mean I don't know about sin? I know about all my sins. I know what I was doing wrong, really. Well, this is a man, duh. And he gave you a love bite, Peter. That's the way the conversation should have gone with me and God. That I had no idea that a man had given me a love bite. I had no idea. I was stuck. I've got a picture, right, Tom, with a ratio at a footballer's house. English League One player. You'll know his name if I say it. I've got a picture of Raish stood with this footballer. And I swear down, when you look at the faces, Raish is only 7 years old. When you look at the faces, Raish has got the same size face as the footballer, if not bigger. Bigger teeth, everything. And at the time, I was oblivious to it. I didn't even notice that that's not Sir David Frost. Alistair Golden. At the time, I had no idea to think your idols were women. Tom, your carry had Bez in her house, right? Right, Tom? Your carry had Bez in her house. Now I can't slag Carrie off for that. I can't slag Kaz off for that, because I've had five agents in my house, at least five agents, and I didn't know, Tom, that they were women. They were all men pretending to be women that I had in this house, and I didn't know. So I can't blame Kaz for having. But, you know, if at the time I didn't know, and Bez or some celebrity said, I'm coming round your house for Christmas, you'd be buzzing, right? You'd think, wow, I've got some celebrity in me. You would think that, Tom. I agree. But she's got no idea, right, that she had a woman kissing her. She kissed another woman on the cheek that she thought was a bloke. The reverse of what I've done. You know, I've kissed a man thinking it was a woman. She's kissed a woman thinking it was a man. And this is the confusion that it's all about, that you can't tell the difference. Oh, that's a nice one, David Frost. You can't tell the difference in men and women. And that's going to be quite shameful when you meet God, right? That he sits you down. He's not going to be mad at you. He's going to sit you down. He's going to tell you gently, you know, you made a mistake. You idolise these fake... I warned you not to idolise fake idols. That's what this is about. Fake idol worship. Do not worship false idols. It's right there. It's biblical, Tom. Thou shalt not have any other God than me, the Father in heaven. He came down from the mountain. There was all worshipping a golden bull. And it still goes on to this day that they worship the golden calf. How do they worship it? They throw babies in a fire. Yeah, that sounds very holy. That sounds very fatherly, doesn't it? That you offer your children to a gold cow. But this is what God pre-warned about. Do not worship the false idols. Or any idol. Do not worship idols. There is only God. Even Jesus said, and he's my hero, Jesus said, no one is good except God. Good God. That's where the saying good God comes from. Save image. One David Frost picture. Oh, don't tempt me. Oh, what have I done there? I don't know why I keep opening them. Is that the second one? No, I've got that one as well. I've got to close that window. There we go. Let's try that again. That's not a good shot either, is it? I kegged Bez and he had what I've got. There you go. You see what I'm telling you, Tom? You was in his presence and didn't know it was a woman. Does that not shock? It shocked me. It literally shocked the life out of me that I had five women in my house, Tom, pretending to be men and didn't notice that one of them was a woman. Two of them got the top off twice, like showing me their FTM bodies, the breasts removed, and I didn't notice either, Tom. Stood right in front of me. Both of them were topless, you know, shirt off like a bloke. And I didn't notice, Tom. No idea that I was stood looking at women. He has what I have, a dick. I said, Tom, so gently. I've seen, he had what I've got. You've seen it. Well, Tom, Bez, I've heard this before as well. Bez. You know they have rubber willies and everything, right, Tom? And if this one did have a willy, it could only open up the possibility that hermaphrodites are real, right? That's all it could be, Tom. I've had a lot of people tell me I've seen this bloke's willy whilst I was at a concert and he came in and stood next to me and pissed. Shiwis. Look up Shiwis first and then tell me that a celebrity can't afford a much better Shiwi than the ones they offer out there for a normal person. But I've seen it. You've seen something. Right? That you've seen something, Tom. It doesn't mean it was a penis, right? It doesn't, Tom. You think you saw a penis. I'll tell you what I see, Tom. I see really close set eyes, small female dentures, no cheekbones look, flat forehead, no brow bone, sloping jawline, pointed chin. Look how close together those eyes are, Tom. Long, narrow face. No neck look, Tom. No neck whatsoever. And there, look at these two. Look at their eyes, Tom. The women, Tom. So whatever this woman had, whatever you saw, we've got two choices, right, Tom? It was either a shiwi. Go look up shiwis. And then tell me that this person wouldn't have... The celebrities get much better shiwis than what they give to normal people, right? Shiwis. Or this person has a penis. It's a woman with a penis. Then it's an hermaphrodite. And I don't believe in hermaphrodites because I haven't seen one. But those two right there, they are girls, Tom. I can tell just by looking at the faces. Doesn't matter if you say you've seen his hair penis. Whatever it was, Tom, it could have been anything. You can't get your head around it. It's a girl, Tom. Look at her posing as Jesus, Tom. She loves to take the fucking pit. This is the bit that gets me mad, Tom. This shit right here, posing as Jesus, right in front of you, Tom. Makes me fucking sick is what it does. Right there. Female bent leg. Female outward pointing knee. It's a woman. Till the cows come home. Look at that bend leg there, Tom. It's not straight, it's bent. Look at the cut and jib of these trousers, trying to hide the female leg from me. But I know it off by heart. I know the female face when I see it. I know when I'm looking at a close-eyed, pink-lipped woman. Never trust a man, Tom, whose eyes are that close together. Let's have a look at the husband. That the husband. Tell me, Tom, who's got the wider face? Who's got the bigger smile? Who's got the wider set eyes look? So whatever this woman had, Tom, I'll bet you it's a fake penis. I'll put you, but even if you saw it pissing out of it, Tom, I'll put your money on it, it's a fake penis. this one's got the dick here. Look at the size of his face, Tom. Look at the jawline on this mofo right here. There, look. Look at the distance in their eyes, Tom. One of these has got a closer set of eyes, look, Tom. Bez, with another bloke. Look, it's a bloke, Tom. So whatever you saw between Bez's legs, I'll put your money on it, it was a shiwi, an expensive shiwi. It could have been a real penis, Tom, which would make this person a hermaphrodite, right? For this person to have a real penis, Tom, a working penis, then this person here must be a hermaphrodite. But I don't believe in hermaphrodites because I've never seen one, Tom. I don't know any, right? I met one on a train once. Apparently, it was a hermaphrodite. I just think it was one of these, a flip-flop. But regardless of what you and I think, the skeleton doesn't lie, Tom. It doesn't. There's a picture somewhere of Bez dancing and the position of his elbow. It's like them basket baseball players where they look like, what is this look? Why is LBG, how many letters? LGBTQIA designer. Beru's Bez. What's the QIA stand for? Queer. I don't know what I is and I don't know what A is. The original letters were LGBT. LBGT. Comes straight out of the Bible. LBGT. Romans. I even know where it comes from. Right, they won't fucking. Right, we'll do it Bible. If you won't find it from the Romans. LGBT in the Bible. The Queen James Bible. Why does that say the Queen James Bible? An anti-LGBT Bible. Interpretations commonly cite only 8 verses in the Bible that they interpret. What? Right, okay, forget about the Queen James. It already is the Queen James. It's not even coming up. Look at this! I can put LBGT into the Bible, into Google, and it's not giving me the quote. You have got to be kidding me. Well, you're having a laugh. You're literally taking the piss. Quote. As if I have to put quote in there. Well, at the back of the Bible, it says, do not lie with a man as he lies with a woman. God loves, he loves you, no exceptions. I agree. Well, look at this. LBGT, and it's not even coming up. Right. Let God be true. Now it'll come up, watch. Romans. There you go. 3-4. Let God be true. LGBT. This is why they use these letters. LGBT. Let God be true. And every man, that includes me, be a liar. I'm telling you now. The life that I'm stuck with. It's bollocks, Tom. Right? Bez knows where you're going, Tom. Right? He knows what. Bez, she knows what she's doing. Yeah. Let God be true and every man a liar. That includes me. Let God be true. Amen. Praise the Lord. Downloads. David Frost, we're done. I've only got 2 gates and I don't care. We're done. David Frost, thanks for playing CSI with me. So, when looking at celebrities, everybody has been fooled. We are stuck in a lie. And until mankind wakes up, there will be no other awakening for us. There won't. I have this God-given innate feeling at the bottom of my gut that God wants us to do something about this. God wants mankind to get up, to rise up and feel him again. And this is it, you know? Oh, sorry, Marlo, did I knock you? Right, Robert Lindsay. I think I've done Robert Lindsay. 2 first names. Copy. Straight away, look. The massive five-head. the rounded closer eyes, the pink lips, the Cupid's bow, all these factors straight away tell you it's a woman. Let me have a look in the back file for Robert Lindsay. I think I've done it. Citizen Smith. I've definitely had a look because it's Citizen Smith. Robert Lindsay, nothing matches. Really? Let me just get rid of Lindsay. Might have spelled it wrong. Robert L. Robert Ladowski. 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 I've got loads of Robert Ladowskis. I haven't done Robert Lindsay. There can't be any Gates. Surely. Yeah. Right, let's continue. I don't really like that face shot. Let's find another one. That's a bit big. It's bigger than 50-50. I want 50-50, Robert. Is that the husband? Again, with a stronger chin right there. Small face. I want a bigger face. We're getting there. Come on, that's almost... Is that 50-50? That looks like it could be 50-50. Right, we'll take that one. It's a small triangle, a big flat forehead, no brow bone, small dentures, sloping jawline, no neck. You can see him right there. Is he playing Captain Hook? He is playing Captain Hook. Oh, it's Panto. All these actors do Panto at Christmas. 10, 20, 30 grand they get per Christmas just for entertaining our children with a load of nonsense. Sorry, Marlo, did I annoy you? He reminds me of someone, I can't think who it is. There's something, it was Gates. Simon Cowell, I'm seeing Simon Cowell. Is that one there? It is, full inline footfall, that's a female all day long. There's a second one, lovely. Have we got a third? Close. My happy days. You're not going to give me another one. Do you know what he looks like there? Stan Laurel. Is he actually playing Stan Laurel there? He must be, surely. No, he's not. Wow, he reminds me so much of Stan Laurel. He looks like Bez as well. Can you not see it? Tom, he looks like Bez. It's the same skull. God says that he'll forgive anyone who wants to repent, including these people, right? But they're not going to. They think they're gods themselves. That's the problem. They think they're higher than God or equal to God. And it's just nonsense. Man can't create anything new. Try. There's nothing new under the sun. That's what God said. It's all been done before, everything. CDs, cars, electric bikes, everything. I can't see another gate. You all right, puppy? I want to go and lay down. Get a drink. There's another good shot. Oh, he's not showing me feet, legs, no, nothing. Christopher Biggins. That's a name I ain't heard for a while. Robert Lindsay walking. Let's try again. See if we can find him. Come on, Robert Lindsay. There's a nice one. What's that? Oh, it is nice. Hello, darling. Oop, and there's another one. Perfect full mints. There's another one. Perfect full mints. I think we're done. Right, we'll take them. Save image. One. Same image. Oh, no. Backwards. Two. Save image. And three. Save image. Four. Oh, I pressed the wrong bloody button. It's got an extra button that the other mouse didn't have. backwards again. Backwards again. I think that's it. Four gates. That'll do. I just need your face. Which one did I settle on? Oh, it's paused up. There we go. Come on. Taking forever. Oh, there's another gate. Fifth. Save image. And I've done it again. Why is it doing that? Oh, I get lost. And there's another one. Oh, I don't need that one. I've got five. I just need your face. But that's the one I settled on, isn't it? Save image. Yeah. Robert Lindsay, two first names, fails forensics, fans playing CSI. Next, John Corbett, JC, Jesus Christ code. AC, DC, and JC. You'll find it in a lot of the names. There's a subreddit on Reddit about space and every other nonsense for people to talk about, thinking stuff is real. Hello, Agent D. How are you doing, mate? That's a close set of eyes, right? Small coffee bean eyes, look, flat forehead. Small dentures, high set ears, no cheekbones. He's got a wonky chin implant, that's it. The neck looks absolutely wrong. Shall we tell that as the face? He's got a long face. She's tall, isn't she? John Corbett. Right, so look, I'll tell that as your face. That's not a good walking picture. Neither. Do you know what? I've got a funny feeling I've done this one. What's his name? John Corbett. I wish it wouldn't do that. Why is it doing that? I've got a different button on the mouse. John Corbett. John Corbett. 1 second. J-O-H-N. Corbett with a C. John C. Reilly. Carson Corbett. Yeah, I've already done it. This one's already done, folks. Let me find a gate. And then I can leave. Walking. And there we go. You can see this person's walking right there as a female. Female gate versus. Oh, it's Sarah Jessica Parker's husband. I didn't realise. Sarah Jessica horse face, straight legs, knees together, space between feet. And then crossed over legs, just like that. There you go. Let's get rid of John Corbett. We've done him. Next, Ellen MacArthur. Do you know what? This is the one that's allegedly a woman, first woman to sail around the world. Let's see if we can get that one. There we go. Paste Ellen MacArthur. The computer says I ain't done him. Let's just put Ellen M in there, see what happens. Nope, we haven't got him. Right, Ellen MacArthur. That means there's no gate. I could have sworn I've looked at this person. So I'm going to go straight to walking pictures. Ding. That looks very straight legged, doesn't it? Perfect straight legs. That's one. Have we got any more? Is that you there, Ellen? We're done. That's a bloke all day long. There's a woman, knees apart, knees together. Who is that? Who's the big girl there? Pat MacArthur meets Ellen MacArthur. Oh, it's Pat MacArthur, whoever that is. Two male gates on Ellen MacArthur. Any more? That looks like a third. It's close. What about that one? Fourth. Nice space. Ain't got any more. There's nothing. There's nothing. That's it. That's all the gates in the world. Do 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 do. Save image. One. It's done it again. What is wrong with that button when I press it? Why is that not going backwards? Backwards. There we go. There's another button there. Three. Ellen MacArthur. Son of Arthur. It's a man. Save image. That's four. And I just need your face, Ellen. That one right there. Look at her neck. Look at her Rolo neck. Square shell. Massive bowling ball size skulls. Square in shape. Save image. And we're done. Ellen MacArthur fails forensics. Thanks for playing CSI with me, Ellen. Next. Paulo Pires. Portuguese television actor. Stage actor. Fashion model. Known for his work in Portuguese, Spanish television. Blah, 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 blah. Personality of the year. Let's have a look at Paulo Pires. we're done on that shot right there. I see separation of the knee, the nice slant that a woman gives. Let's go back a picture, sorry. And we'll pick a face. Why is that not going backwards? There we go. Let's pick a face first. Closer eyes, closer. He looks, you know what he looks like? He looks like the Dutch Prime Minister for a split second. Crow's feet, look. Small dentures, high set ears, flat forehead. Is that a good enough picture? That's pretty big, actually. Too small. That one. We're going to take that as the face. A beautiful eyes, flat forehead, no brow bone, high set ears, sloping jawline, rounded slash pointed chin. Who's got the bigger teeth? Of course, it's the husband, look, with the far apart eyes. The big teeth and the square jaw. Look how square and flat this jaw is. There he is in all his glory. The male skeleton over dominating the female here with the closer eyes. Let's go back a picture. I'm tempted to do them both, you know. No, we'll just do him. Go back, go back. That's the one. Right, gate shopping. What's his name? Paulo Pires. Pires. I've never heard of him. He's Portuguese. She is Portuguese. Portuguese. We're just looking for gates. Please, thank you. Any time today. Oh, he's got big arms, hasn't he? Oh, look at the... Oh, that's just ridiculous. The one in the red dress is just ridiculous. You're lucky we don't do children. There's what I'm looking for, right there. Female gate. Give me that picture. Why is it paused? You bugger. Do we have to go back now to find that picture? That's annoying. That was a good gate as well. Take me back. There we go. There, that's the one we're looking for, right there. Lovely, full female gate, one. We'll take that as a second as well. Let's see if we can't find a third. Oh, look, I left my coffee. Too shoddy shy. Hush, hush, I'm out of pictures. Let's go for walking, shall we? Oops. Walking. You ain't got no more gates. That was it. Well, that's a weird picture. Oh, that's why. My bad. Paulo Pires. There's a second gate right there. But that's it. Two gates. It's nothing. Literally nothing. What's that one there? Can't quite see it. Got that one. What's this one here? Flamingo foot. I can take that. Right, we've got three gates. That'll do. One. One. Backwards. It's paused. Come on, doofuses. Did I press the button? No, I didn't. There's an extra button there. I don't know why it's there. Sometimes it doesn't work, apparently. And then one more, I think. Where's the one on stage? Oh, two more. My bad, we got him. Five. I didn't think we got five, but we did. And there's the fifth. Save image, and then we'll take your face. And just like that, boys and girls, Ana Sousa, Paulo Pires became female. Who knows what God's going to do. It's all in good. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. We're looking at Igor Cavalera. He's a Brazilian musician, best known former drummer, every better man, Sepultura. Never heard of him. Images, Fuzzy Wuzzy was a woman. No brow bone look, flat forehead, very wide at the top in the hairline. Skull as wide as the neck look. You see, with a man, this should be broad and flat. This should be longer. And this neck, if it was that wide, then the face should be even wider. It should look like a lollipop on a stick, and it does not. We'll take that as your face, closer eyes, flat forehead, no brow bone. I know your lips are pink. High-ish set of ears, sloping jawline, covered the pointy chin with a fake beard. Excuse me. Let me just sit up. So, I'm wedged in that corner. You all right, Marley? What's up? You want a wee-wee? You want a wee-wee? You do want a wee-wee. Come on, man. 1 second, folks. I'm just going to put Marlo out. Come on. Oh, my leg. I've been sat on that leg for an hour and something. It's dead. I nearly fell over, Marley. Here, come on. There you go, pups. Do, 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 do. Go on, have a wee wee. You didn't even have a wee wee. Go and have a wee wee. Go on. Go and do a wee wee. Go on. If I have to shut that door, that's it. When I want you, you do. Oh yeah, that'll get you in, won't it? The sound of a rustling packet. Go on, take that chicken. That'll bring you in, won't it? The sound of chicken. You coming up? Ali up. Thank you. Right, sorry, I'm back. Keyboard, mouse. What's his name? Igor. Who cares? This is the hard bit for a lot of them. They see men. They really do. They see men, don't they? And trying to tell them that that's a these are women, they can't see it. What is that? I'm so confused. Is that him? That's not him, is it? What are we looking at here? That is him. Oh, that's a woman all day long, look. No neck, no chin, close set, droopy eyes, pink lips, Cupid's bow. It's a woman all day long. Is that really him? That really is him when he was younger. I've done it again. That button should not be there. What is that button? Oh, I'm hitting the side. Never mind. 1 second, let me get rid of that. Right. Okay. We are looking at Igor, and that is just unfathomable. Look at that. What is going on there? That is him, right? Is it? Yeah, I swear down that is. I'm taking that picture. Save image. I'm sure it's him. Do you know what? I don't think we're going to get this one walking. There's no gates. What's this? What does that mean?
Yeah.
Oh, I know what that one means. Tell me you're a Satanist. Without telling me you're a Satanist. There's nothing. nothing. Let's try and walk it. I don't think we're going to get this one. I think we're going to fail. I should have seen something at least. Yeah, there's nothing. Oh, maybe. What's this? Which one is him? Here. Max and Igor Cavalero. There's two of them. She's mincing. That one's mincing. That one's mincing. And we've got a flamingo. That's my girl there in flamingo. Right. It is. That one there, that's my girl, is it? Or is it this one? I can't tell which one's which. I think it is that one. Right, so it's the Chubby Chops. No, he's done it again. Keep pressing the wrong button. It's a little bit further over. That one, there we go. So that is him in flamingo. But that's it, I think, folks. We're out of pictures. That's it. That's the only gate for this person. Let me try public. See if we can get him that way. Yeah, we've got no gates. Oh, no. Oh. No, he's standing. No pictures of this person walking. We're done. There's no pictures. I'm out of here. Next. Richie Campbell. Two first names. Open image. She's got a long neck, though, for a woman. I'll give her that. No Adam's apple. There's no pictures. We're leaving. Oh, maybe there is some. I don't know which Richie Campbell you was after. There's two of them. Let's go back to the top. Let's have a look. Singer or actor? Oh, I don't know. We're going to go with the actor. You didn't specify. Richie Campbell. We'll start with that picture. Close set eyes look. Cupid's bow, small pouty mouth, sloping rounded jawline. We've got no brow bone. Look, there's nothing in the corners. Literally nothing in the corners of the eye. Those short eyebrows that women get, look. There they are. Short ass eyebrows. We just need gates. We'll take that as your face, Richie. There's nothing. Looks like we're leaving. Walking. Search. There we go. We're done. There's no pictures. Go back to all. Let's get rid of that. He said it's not. He said it's a singer. Alright, let's have a look again. Richie Campbell, Portuguese singer. Right. There you go. And it's still showing me the other one. This one's a woman, though. This is the one, right? The long, narrow face. Look, the pink lips, the high set ears, the close set eyes, the flat forehead. We'll take that as your face, that one there. That looks 50-50. See if we can find a gate. It's showing me the other Richie Campbell still. It's annoying. That's my girl there, though, by the look of it. It is, with a nice diamond between the legs. It's not a good shot, though. Not a good shot. I swear down, I thought that said the FTMs. I really did. I thought that said FTM. The FTM. That was funny. Can we please, please have a gate? Nothing. Right, let's try again. Walking. There's nothing. I ain't even got any pictures, look. We're leaving. See you later. Next. Lawrence O'Donnell. American actor, TV, television anchor. Lawrence O'Donnell. That's quite a five edge you got there, my dear. She has got distance in her eyes, but it's a small face. It's a small triangle look. But there's too much skull to be a man. There's just too much skull there, look. We call it the five head for a reason. Let's see if we can get him walking. There's something. It's no good, it's no good, it's no good, it's no good. That's a fella right there. Oh, dang it, that was a fella right there. Did you see him? Let's see if we can't find the gate. Oh, 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 no. It's a crowd. Same picture again. Same pictures again. We're out of pictures. Walking. Walking. Try again. There's nothing. Yeah, there's nothing. See ya. Next. Connie Smith, American singer, songwriter, country music singer. Her contralto vocals have been described as music writers as significant influential to the women of this world. Who's that? She's got coffee bean eyes, whoever it is. Connie and Marty. Never heard of Marty. Marty's a bit small though, isn't she? Oh, she sat down, I'll let you off. That is a brow bone to be proud of. Look how deep set those eyes are. Strong neck as well. Is that an Adam's apple? It looks like Adam's apple. Someone's like, women have Adam's apples too. Yeah, but you can't see them. They're not on show like a man's is. A woman has to be leaning forward or really shouting for you to see the ripple of a female Adam apple. Dum, dum, dum. Men have got 40% bigger necks. Give me a break. Longer, thicker. Because it supports a heavier, denser skull. There are no gates on Connie Smith. Literally nothing. Stand by your man. That is a huge dude, isn't it? Look at the size of his head. Hid. right, we're done. Connie Smith walking. Wasting my life, I think. Where are we? Walking. Yeah, we're done. Connie Smith got a big, massive man head, bowling ball size skull. But there are no gates for your Connie Smith at all. There's nothing. Leaving next. Tom Hell, Norwegian singer, songwriter. Tom Hell, his birth name, Thomas Helland. Released several EPs and albums from Norway. Must be for Harold. Let's have a look. Images. That's a woman all day long. Close set, droopy eyes, look. Five head. Dial M. For Mongo's. What's wrong with that mouse? Oh, it got stuck. It's at an angle. We could take that as the face. It looks 50-50. See if we can get his gait. Norwegian singer. Goodbye. He stands like a woman, that's for sure. Don't ya? Definitely stands like a woman. There it is again. Out of pictures. Uh oh. I think we're leaving. That's the end of that. Walking. Oh, there's one. From Flamingo, by the look of it. It's not a clean picture. I can't see his feet, but that looks like an outward pointing knee from this position. But there are no pictures, look. Literally no pictures. We're done. I'll give you a second shot of the cake. Public. No, I changed my mind. There you go. It's a man. straight legs, trying to walk like a woman. We're going to need some more pictures. Where is it at? Oh, there we go. There's a male gate. Click. Done. One. There's two. Come on, give me more. Keep them coming. As if you're only going to give me two. Let's carry on. What is that? Oh, is that him? We're done. That's a bloke. Straight leg, knee pointing forward, foot pointing. That's a man all day long. That is a man, 1,000%. End of story. Follow the widest bit up. Beep, 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 beep. It's above the crotch. Thanks for playing CSI. We just need... how many? Two more gates. Stair fails perfect, though. We're out of pictures. Bobby Altoff. We don't usually get the YouTubers, but this one, we got. Mm-hmm.
We got one!
I got a YouTuber. It's taken ages, but we got one. Any more gates for me whilst we're on this screen? Bobby. No. Oh, no. That's the same one. We're out of pictures. I got three gates. I'm happy with that. It's a YouTuber. We don't usually get them. Stair fail. Save image. One. Come on now. There we go. And two. Oh, Daily Mail. Oh, Daily Mail. Daily Mail, let me have it. Thank you very much, Daily. There we go. And one more. Save image. Save, and just that's it. I just need his face, right? Let's get his noggin. That was a nice picture right there. 50-50, where was it? Has it changed picture? No. There, that one. We'll try that one as a 50-50. No, it's smaller. That one's 50-50. Right, it's a bit bigger, but we'll take it. We'll take that picture. What's his name? Bobby Altoff. Oh, he's having a baby. I'm going to have a baby. He's having a fart. What he's done is ate himself four tins of baked beans and he's busting for a poop. That's the truth on that. It's a bloke pushing his belly out. Next. Jens Stoltenberg. Do you know what? I might have done this one. Name. Jens. Let's have a look in the back file. Paste. I have done it. It's already been done. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's perfect. That don't need doing. I'll give you a shot of his image, of his gait, hair gait. Straight away with the face. Crow's feet, flat forehead, closer eyes. It's a small triangle, too much skull up top. Jens Stoltenberg walking. I had 5 perfect minces, so this should be easy. And there you go, we're done. Flamingo foot, first picture with a mincer on the right. Is that Holland's president, prime minister, the one with the boobs? I can't remember what they call him. We've already done it though. Jens Stoltenberg, it's a girl. Thanks for playing CSI. Next. Head. Move your head. Next. Right, so we'll continue on. We are looking at TV license ads. No, we've done that. We spoke about that. Rip Torn, we spoke about that. That bit in Freddy Got Fingered, where he plays the father and he's bent over with his, pulling his underpants down, telling his son, oh my gosh, just at the time when I watched it, I was dying. That Freddy Got Fingered made me weep with laughter. It was so outrageous. But in hindsight, the stuff that they put in that, it was gross. The abuse, etc. Next. Dapper Laughs. Dapper Laughs? British content creator. What is that? Like YouTube or something? Dapper Laughs 841. 1,000 followers. Images. Dapper Laughs. Oh, we're done. First picture. Pink lips. Never, ever. Well, that's a woman. Never, ever, 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 ever underestimate pink lips on a man. Soft eyes. No brow bone. Vertical forehead. Small ears. That's a woman. It's a woman's skull. Widest in the hairline, look. Up there, widest. No neck. Adam's raisin implant. I quite like that for a face shot. That's 50-50. Right, Dapper, we're going to need some... Oh, you're done. We're done. It's a woman. No man opens his knees like this when walking. That is the Cockney wide boy. Shoulder tilt, hip twist, and full triangle. It's a woman rotating hips. End of. It's a woman. Is that another one? Please give it... Oh, look at that female Q line. And no feet for me to see. There's in line. There's in line. We've got you, Dapper. It's a woman. Look at the size of those hips. She looks demented. Remember to hail Satan in front of everyone. Just remember you're hailing Satan because that's your God. They are losing their religion. Oh no, I've said too much. The distance in your eyes. My nana said, never trust a man whose eyes are too close together. End of story. There's another nice one there. We'll take that one as well. Have we got any more? Dapper with your five head. Oh look, where have we seen that before? Where have I seen that before? There we go. Images. Where's that picture? It better be here. I better have taken it away. I've got it anyway. Even if it's not there. Bitch. Where was that picture taken? Was it in a court? It wasn't in a court, surely. It's not there. It didn't work for tongue either. How about fingers? Fingers. Try that. Come on, you bitch. Where's that picture? You do not want to look at that one, though. JFK and Wernher von Braun. This is Hitler's top rocket scientist on the left with the big hips. Both of them mincing before they fake the moon landings. Look at this, you pair of traitors. They're all like, JFK was a good guy. He's not even a guy. First of all, let's get that right. And there, look at this. What is he doing there? What is that? Oh, it's the Freemasonry sign that also means flat earth. What are chances? What are chances of them putting it right in your face? There's nothing there. There's another one. Let's try Tommy Robinson doing it. Robinson. Tongue. There's a few of them doing it. It don't want to show me that one either. You bunch of the Google hiding pictures from us, both of them. I've got a picture somewhere with both Tommy Robinson and Wernher von Braun and someone else all doing that. All of them doing that. I don't know what it's what its meaning is. Do you know what that reminds me of there? I saw Leonardo DiCaprio for a split second. Look at the head on that damn thing. We're done. Dapper laughs. Fails forensics. Absolutely female. A stair fail would be nice, Dapper. Just to finish you off. Stands like a girl. It's got a nice McDonald's archway between them legs. Look at it. It's built like an house. Look, looks like an house under there. Men's legs, just they'd be straight. It'd look more like a triangle than it would like a house. Yeah, it'd just be this section here. Dapper laughs. You little boss-eyed. Is that him getting knocked out? Knocked down Simple Simon. Whoever Simple Simon is. I don't know. Maybe the sworn enemies. Look at that. James MacArthur. Ah, as if you're not going to show me that picture. It's lagging. Why is it lagging now? Look, a red line. There we go. Right, I don't think there's any more gates in that section. I think I've got them all. I'm looking though. He's got a lot of pictures. There we go, we're done. Let's go walking and then we can go back and grab him. Look at this, I put walking in, nothing comes up, look. I found four gates. Oh, is that the same? Ooh, nice triangle. Just a few seconds earlier, it would have been a stair fail. Right, we've got Dapper. We don't need any more gates. We're done. What's that? Mark Powell. It's a woman. It is a woman. No man opens his knee outwards like this. Flamingo foot. All day long, Mark Powell. And there it is. Full female gait with bent legs and a diamond in between showing. She's a girl. Right, let's go back. Back. And we'll take from there. That's a nice shot. One. Two. Three. That's the one. That's the money shot. And he's holding up double devil horns. She is holding up double devil horns as she does it. That's a nice cue line. We'll take it. Arms akimbo. Swaying away from the body to avoid contact with the hips. She's a lady. Shoulder tilt. And we just need your face. Dapper laughs. No. I think we'll take that one. Save image. Done. Dapper laughs. Internet celebrity. Usually we don't get anything from YouTube. But this one, is because he's been on television. She's been on television. We nailed her. Thanks very much for playing CSI. Dapper. Next, Ryan Reynolds. We've sorted that one. Human eyeball. Even Darwin said, in 20 billion years, to assume that the eyeball would form is nonsense. Next, Chloe Sims bikini. Have we already looked at this one? We have, because he's got a P-E-N-I-S. Ooh, look at that. For all of you that are new to this.
Oh, you touch my tra-la-la. My ding-ding-dong.
Ding-ding-dong. We've already done this one, so let's get rid of that one. Chloe Sims, see you later. Megan King, we've done that one, see you later. Jacob Flickinger, I don't know who this is. Let's get rid of that full stop. Top stories, parents condemn son's death in Gaza. Oh, this is a news story, is it? Right, images, double look. Bum, bum, bum. Fuzzy Wuzzy was a woman. I see a woman. I see soft, shiny eyes straight away. Where was that picture that I just saw? That, no. There. Well, I'm just saying now, that is a flat back straight away. He's got a big... He has got from shoulder to elbow. Look at the length of this arm. Look at the length of that. And then look at this one. This is a woman and this is a man. We won't mention the baby. Baby's innocent. Let's have a look at you. Is that him? That's a tiny chest. They are really short clavicles. You got some sloping shoulders there. Mummy with boobs. Missing. Is that you? We're done. That's a woman. That's a woman till the cows come home. That's a woman, 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 woman. All day long, that's a woman. There's a diamond in there that shouldn't be there. It's an inline footfall. Even though I can't see your lead foot, that's a woman. All major news stories are absolute tosh, made up nonsense, propaganda to instill fear and allow more of your true freedoms to be taken away in the name of their practical jokes. That's what it is, right? These are the practical jokers. You think Sal Volcano and the other ones are the practical jokers, but no. These are the practical jokers in the world, pulling off worldwide pranks and not getting caught. People believing it. Walking. Do. Give me another one. Is that you there? Nope. All these things are staged. Think of movie sets. And actors, and then you've got your answer. You really do. Let's go back. We've got one gate. That's all I've got. I'll take it, seeing as it's a famous story. Do we need? We need a better face. I'm tempted to do that one. We'll cover up the baby, and we'll do you both. We'll see what happens. Next. Jermaine Greer, we've already dealt with that one. The Baphomet, we've already dealt with that one. Bruce Lee's Wonky Nips, we've dealt with that one. Oh, I didn't finish the story off, did I? Is that one still? It is. So, apparently this is a Mason, flat earth, drinking water, damp, whatever. When I said that Hollywood was full of pedophiles and nonsense and there's no good coming out of it, the groan, the literal groan that came out of this Mason's mouth, all here, I can't show you it because that channel's gone, but this one was just like so let down. Like, this one had something lined up. Don't ask me what. But this one had something lined up. And it had something to do with Spiros. Spiros at Michalakalakalis. I spoke to this one twice. The second time, Flat Earth Karen B came in and took over. So still, I didn't get to fully grill Spiros. In fact, even on the first time I met this person, on a webcast, it was all done through the Flat Earthers, this one, Jibby, it was all done through them. It was none of my doing to speak to this person, but I was allowed to speak to this person on a live Flat Earth channel podcast, I didn't even have an inkling that this was a woman, right? It's a very tall woman, gets to sit with, what do they call him? Marvel Magic, he's the Marvel, Stan, whoever it is, Stanley Hanley, whatever they call him, gets to stand with this person because Spiros apparently does all the physics for the Marvel movies. And they set up a chat between me and Spiros. I had no idea who Spiros was or how famous it was. Someone was trying to tell me this was Sacha Baron Cohen in a face mask. See, they all do it. They all want to tell you, Stan Lee, thank you, Harold. Two first names, Stan Lee. They all want to tell me that this is Sacha Baron Cohen. It is not Sacha Baron Cohen in a face mask. Sacha Baron Cohen. It is not Borat. The similarity comes from the long face, right? The long, elongated female skull with the close-set eyes. Right, it does look similar. Remember, these are bloodlines, all from the same roots. So they have, the women have wide bowling ball skulls and the men have long faces. FTM walks into a bar and the bartender says, why the long face? This is not Spiros Michalakalakalis. That is not the physician. Spiros Michalakalis is not Sacha Baron Cohen. It does look like, I'll give you that, it does look like David Copperfield. It really does look like David Copperfield. I'll give you that. It's more David Copperfield. But again, I think, Roberta, it's the bloodline. It's the family traits, you know. If you come from a certain country, you look a certain way. And I think it's that that's doing it. This picture was what alerted me when I first started doing forensics, that I'd been speaking to a woman. And they all knew I'd spoken to a woman. And in fact, I went back to the actual interview where I meet Spiros Michalakalakalis. I went back to the actual video when I met him, and there's a bit at the end where he stands up and you can see she's pulling down a t-shirt to hide her hips as she stands up, very conscious. And then all of the people in that room, the Flat Earthers, I can't remember any of, don't ask me to remember the names, I can't. They were all new faces to me at the time. So I didn't know the people properly. I can't remember any of the names. I can just remember who was on the panel with me. But Spiros, I've already covered this person. Chin implant, everything else is female. The close set eyes, the flat forehead, the high set ears, the pink lips. Cupid's bow's been removed. But no neck, sloping shoulders, and of course the hips. I think I found two gates when I went through this. What's up, Marley? Right, get off. We're not going anywhere. Get off, you div.
No, you want cuddle.
you little ginger furball. Get off. Stop it. We're not fighting. We're not playing. Don't crawl in. Don't think you're coming in there. You're not. Get off. I'm trying to get in over the keyboard. Right. So, Spearus Michalakalakalis. I don't know if I'm saying the name right. That's just what I called her when I met her. Is a massive astrophysicist, right? He works in the land of Lala, basically, right? Spearos told me that he could, using Einstein's theory of relativity equation, he could tell me what the moon weighed. Now, nobody's even drilled into the moon, right? No one's been on it. It's all bollocks. But even if they could, and they have, like they say, Neil brought some cuttings, stones and rock, whatever, right? Even if they drilled a bit, they didn't drill into the centre of the moon to know what's in it. They can't know what's all over the moon, what it's made of. For all I know, half of it's gold, the other half is piss. I've got no idea, right? And neither do they. But they say they can measure the moon by looking at it. I pulled up a bottle, didn't tell them what was in it. Using your equation, tell me what's in the bottle. You can't. Even if I show you a barrel. Actually, it wasn't a bottle, it was a barrel. We said a barrel at the time. I've got a barrel. I filled it with certain items. I'm not telling you what it is, tell me what it weighs. Spearos kept asking me over and over, but what's in the barrel? What's in the barrel? Well, you can't know what's in the barrel. Just like you can't know what's in the moon. Just like you don't know what's in the earth. It's all made up caca, poo-poo. Straight out of la-la land, out of places. The only place that space exists, for those that believe in space, is between your effing ears, where your brain used to be. The space lies between your ears, where your brain used to be. That's space right there. It's made up. It's in your numpty. Spearos Michalakalakalis. I think I went to video to find this one walking, and he only did it because they put this person in my life. I believe that when I was slagging Hollywood off, there was something in the pipeline, I don't know, maybe with Spearos, maybe with someone else, for me to do a talk. You know, they did loads of movies, didn't they? Beyond the Cave, all of this stuff, but it was all done by those people. It was all done by these people, not by a man like me, to even put me close to film. The only way you could do it is if I wasn't live. Then you can edit everything that I say out, right? All the truth that I spat, you can edit it all out. You can even make me say things that I didn't say, right? But I believe that's what they were after. They wanted me to have some interaction with the film industry. And I totally squee-whiffed it the minute. It was someone in the chat said, Dan doesn't think that they're all bad in Hollywood. The amount of shite that has come out of Hollywood, the film-wise, leaves me just speechless. It does. The things that the images that these people have put in my head from films alone, from horror movies and the rest of it, murder movies and all the shite I've watched, it should never have been there. If I didn't have a television and I didn't watch their crappy movies, I would never have had images put into my mind's eye ever. Loads of it would have. He's got a big nose. She's got a big nose, hasn't she, that one? I don't know who she is, but she's got a big nose, coffee bean eyes. Let's go back. So when it comes to Masons, and bearing in mind I spoke to Sergeant as well quite a few times, out of all of them I like Sergeant. I did like Sarge. She was nice to be around, was Sarge. These ones that I find kind of Dan and the rest of them that tagged in because of Sarge speaking to me and that. The other ones that tagged along were a bit more conniving and sinister, I found, in their ways. But regardless, all my information, is that me there? Open that. No, that's not me. I thought it was going to show, but I might be on there, I don't know. But there were faces there that I recognise. This one. That one, Russian videos. I think I even recognise this one.
I spoke to a lot of these Masons online because I was a real man in their environment. I didn't know about the skeletons. If I did, I would have spotted these people quicker. I would have heard it in the voices faster. But I didn't. When I met this woman online, they told me it was an astrophysicist and he was a man. Both are bollocks. Astrophysics don't work, and this is a woman pretending to be a man. It's not a man, it's the same thing, it's fake. And it's the fakeness of this world that absolutely just destroys me. It does. Yeah, I watched Russian vids for years as well. For years and years, I watched Russian vids. Right, Dan the Waterman, another one. Next, Carlo Maria Vigiano is a Catholic Church bishop. Nuncio. Okay, I don't think we're going to get gates on this person. Very rare we do, because they wear effing robes. But we'll have a quick look down. Straight away, I see a woman. I see an egghead, widest in the hairline, look, right up there. Wider at the top, look, in the hairline, than it is in the cheekbone. And that's wrong. It's an egg-shaped face. It's an upside down. They're all in on it. All the pastors, the popes, they've all been women. You've had no male popes, no male bishops, no male cardinals. That's why they get to sit next to Donna with a close set of eyes. That functions with them. All the nuns are men. Dude! You ever seen the nun that throws an 80 mile an hour fastball? Yeah, there's no pictures. Let me just have a quick look walking. It'll save me time. Even if I could get him, look, he's in damn robes. That's not him, though. Inline footfall, even under the robes, look. But that's not him. And there are no pictures. All I can give you is the female skull check. And that's it. I'm not going to make a skull check. I don't do skull checks on their own anymore. Anytime anyone sees me doing just a single skull check on one of my posts, it's an old picture. I haven't done single skull checks for a long, long time. I like the gates. It stops all debates. Next, Tina Cipollari from Italy. Right, let's have a quick look. Images. Oh, that, we're done. That's a dude. That right, Dowell Anna, that's what I'm seeing. Open that picture. There you go. Male clavicles, thick neck, storm drain in the neck, look. See it? Male trachea. Square shadow casting job, been feminized, big mouth. Deep set eyes, thick brow bone in the corner of the skull. It's wide but short and sloping, look. Let's have a look at your girlfriend. She's got the soft face, look. Can't smile properly, close set eyes. The difference is there once you learn to look for it. It really is. The male bowling ball size skull versus the tic-tac with the wide, wide hairline, look. Dial M for Mongo's. We're looking at... what's his name? Tina Cipollari. Tina Cipollari. Again, with a long face, look. The long face woman versus the wide face man. Tina Cipollari. I think we can take that one. No. That one's better. Do you know who he reminds me of? Rebel Wilson. Now that Rebel Wilson's lost a load of weight. That's who it reminds me of. Right, let's see if we can get his... his gait. He's got a big hand. I just saw it then. Is he a chef? I just saw chefs. I saw a few chef pictures all at once. He's not. He's not a chef. No gates. Italiano. Not out of gates. Tina... Cipollini, I don't know what his name was, who cares? It won't matter when I meet God, enter. Oh, we got no gates. Unless that's one there, no. What about that one? Oh, I think that is a gate. Knees together versus knees apart, look. One. That might be another one. Oh, I just can't see that back leg, that's a shame. One. It's not enough. I'm out of pictures. I can't do it on one. Is that another one? No pictures. Right, there's no gates. Next. Nikola Tesla's wife sorted that one next. Stephen Hawking couldn't speak a word in English. There is no God, Stephen Hawking. There is no Stephen Hawking. God, wonderful, beautiful, flat earth. Ryan Gosling covered that already. Next. Ronaldo covered her already. Next. Jessica DeGaulle. Did we look at this one? Did we not already do this one? Why am I on his face? That's a dude. I swear we did this one the other day. Let's have a look. Walking, we did. Get off my screen. Next. Did that one as well. Deirdre Kelly, next. We did that one as well. Lisa Navak. We did that one as well. Willa Holland. Sally Nugent, we've done. Oh, boom, shaka, waka, waka, waka. Boom, shaka. Oh, there we go, to the end. Gotcha. It's time. Is it time? Is it really? It's time, boys and girls. Right. We will be back tomorrow. We will open up with live requests. If you've got a request for me, be sure to be here tomorrow at 8 p.m. When I start requests. Tonight, I'm done. It's late. I've been going 2 hours 31 minutes. God wants you to know that you are very special, and He also wants you to know that you were born in an inside out. Hello, Lynn McIntyre. He wants you to know that you were born in an inside out, upside down, back to front, tipsy, topsy turvy world. I'm gonna go play some Call of Duty with Chris. You all take care, and just remember, God does love you. We'll see you tomorrow for live request, 8 o'clock.